Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us at this last talk at Portal 2 today, at day two of Odoo Connect. This last talk is Faisal Basar, CTO, Chief Technology Officer at Bista, an Odoo Gold partner. And as you can read right there, the topic is going to be how integration and automation can transform your manufacturing options. So let's give a little welcome to Faisal and get going with the talk.
It's always fun to be the last talk of the day. You know, it's so exciting. So today we are going to talk about, I'll make a small introduction about what Bista Solutions is. We will be talking about what roadblocks manufacturing companies face and how Odoo can help in those challenges. We'll also talk about a case study of what we did and what kind of results we got for the customers. But before I start, how many of you are like associated with manufacturing, work for a company which does manufacturing or even implement for manufacturing? Okay, so we have quite a few. That's good to know. So Bista Solutions is a gold partner. We are essentially an enterprise solutions implementation company. We are local here in the Bay Area, but we have presence in Canada, in UAE, and in India. We focus on ERP solutions, but once we implement ERP, we also implement analytics solutions for our customers and machine learning solutions. We are related to Odoo. We are gold partners of Odoo. We've been associated with Odoo for a long time in the US, one of the earliest partners of Odoo. Fabrice talked about their growth, and we were there when they started with Odoo in US as one of their partners. We got Best Partner Awards in 2015, 16, and 18. And we're growing very fast, and all our growth is organic. So talking about the challenges faced by manufacturing companies, it's the first thing is decentralized data. We've talked to a lot of companies, and generally most of the companies, small to medium-sized companies which are in manufacturing, have at least three different systems to run their operations, right? So one would be their sales or the CRM system. The other one would be the one which they actually run manufacturing on, which might actually be outdated. And the third might be an accounting system. So the problem with this is you have data which is decentralized into different systems. You have your customers in your CRM, which are not the same in your accounting system, and your manufacturing orders are not related to your sales orders. So you cannot keep track of when you're going to deliver to your customers. Right? So this is very typical we see of manufacturing companies. And most important for companies is whether, depending on your type of manufacturing, to have insights into your supply chain. So firstly, from the procurement side, to have a robust MRP process is very important, so that you can, when you get an order from a customer, whether you are doing customized make-to-order products, or even if you're doing make-to-stock, when you get a customer order, to tell the customer of when they expect their shipment, you need complete visibility into your manufacturing process, into your supply chain, what is in your inventory, how much time it takes for you to order stuff, get it, and manufacture it. And this is not possible unless you have an integrated system. So what Odoo can do for you is, essentially, Odoo has a comprehensive solution for manufacturing companies. Odoo recently, in the few versions, they implemented manufacturing planning and scheduling, right? So that is one very important functionality for manufacturing companies, where they can use something called the master production schedule to plan their production, right? And this, the good thing is it is completely integrated with your supply chain, right? So essentially, if you get an order from a customer today, you know what is your manufacturing time, but you also know what is the lead time for your supply chain to deliver the raw materials, so that you can calculate and tell a fixed and accurate delivery date to your customer. This is what Odoo enables you to do. It also enables you to do product life cycles, and we have for some of our smaller customers, we have implemented product life cycle management within Odoo itself. We have also, for our more advanced customers who have a very complicated product life cycle process, we have also implemented separate PLM tools within Odoo. So they do the product engineering, and the engineering team uses an external PLM tool. And then we, in Odoo, we import the data, we import the latest version of their bill of materials, and use that in Odoo for the manufacturing process. So it can be multiple. You can either use an external PLM tool and use Odoo for manufacturing, or also use Odoo for maintaining your bill of material versions and so on. With regards to CRM, you can have insights into your customers, which Odoo gives, and the other regular features about financially managing your customers in one system, right? So when you have when you get an order from your customer and you need to see how much is the credit limit for that customer, Odoo enables all of that in one system, because your accounting is integrated with your CRM system. So I want to talk about a case study which is very important, and you can probably relate to it. This is a furniture manufacturing company in Cleveland, Tennessee, where we implemented. Now, this company had they were into contract manufacturing, essentially. So, and you might be able to relate to this. So their manufacturing was very custom. So they would have orders for their furniture, which was custom manufactured, and they wanted this and they wanted the system to manage that, which means when you have when you're selecting furniture to manufacture, there are multiple options available for that, and there are certain rules, right? So there are certain, you know, Odoo has a configurator, and I'll show you what we did with the configurator. There are certain rules of, hey, if you have this type of fabric, then you can only use this in a chair. You can only use the arms can be of this type. So there are multiple rules which are in configurable product, which needs to be set up when you're placing the order. Now, another challenge we hear a lot from customers is the bill of materials. Depending on what you're doing, it could be, some customers want dynamic bill of material, right? So you want to be able to create your bill of materials on the fly if you are working with configurable products. And this is what one of the customizations we did, which I will show you about this customer. But a little bit stepping back about the challenges which this customer was facing. Essentially, they were, the value they were adding to the customers was custom ordered furniture in a very short lead time, right? So that is the value which they had for their customer, and their systems were not enabling them to give the delivery to the customer in a short lead time. And then also we had the problem, as I mentioned, of a product configurator. So there were a lot of rules when you come up to manufacturing, say, a complicated piece of furniture, on what options when you're configuring the product, on what options are compatible with each other, right? So that logic was not there. And it's not there in any system, and we actually made it for them. And thirdly, it's they wanted visibility into their production process processes. So they in furniture manufacturing and in other type of orders, we have something called customer owned inventory. So your customer will actually provide you with raw material, and you will manufacture it and then deliver the products to the customer. So that is, for that you need entire visibility into your production process, which we enabled for them. So this is a statement from our customer. Before they planned, they were implemented an ERP system. They looked at Oracle and SAP, and this is their testimonial. We have it on our website. You can look it up. The cost to implement Odoo was almost 10 to 15 times. The cost of Oracle and SAP was 10 to 15 times that of Odoo. And the timeline was almost 18 months. Now, this is very complicated project where we also had, they had legacy systems and they could not do away, like they wanted all the data to be carried over from the past years into Odoo so they can manage their customers, their orders, and all that. So this is one challenge with customers. When you are replacing your ERP, it's a big change, but you have, your business is in operation, right? You have customer orders, you have manufacturing orders which are open, you have inventory, you have placed orders with your vendors which is on the way, right? How do you migrate all of that into all of the information about a running business into an ERP system and start running with it, right? So this takes a lot of planning and a lot of effort. So this is what we help them out with. So our entire process from start to end, including data migration, including training, was completed within within 12 months as compared to 18 months, which some of the other companies were proposing. So we started with a detailed business analysis, talk to the customers, understand what how they run their business. They had some very unique business processes. And this is where a partner like Bista comes in the picture, where if you have any unique processes which you need to be understood, we have experts who are from the manufacturing domain, who worked for many years, come and talk to you, understand your processes, and see what is the best way to map it into Odoo, and if you need any customizations, what customizations need to be done. So there are certainly some companies which need customizations because their processes are unique, right? So we did the entire process. We did data migration. We have a user training. We also had a UAT process. Generally, we give at least 2 months for user acceptance testing. UAT stands for user acceptance testing, which serves a dual purpose of training the users, preparing them for the new system, and also testing the system. So what we do in UAT is we take a snapshot of your current operations, migrate it to Odoo, and give it to users as if they have started, they're already on Odoo. So they will be able to receive orders which were on the way. They will be able to process their manufacturing orders which are in process. And that's why we give a lot of time for user acceptance testing, because it's very important that when we go live and we flip the switch and turn on the new ERP system, they are all prepared. There are no surprises. So this is one very important step in our process for user acceptance testing. So some of the metrics which we actually measured for them, the invoicing process would take around 30 minutes. And after our implementation, it took 3 minutes. The reason being, their systems were disjoint, they were not connected, and it used to take a lot of time to do the invoicing process. Curation of bill of materials was reduced from 3 hours to 3 minutes. And I will show you what we actually did, because it was custom products. They had to create the bill of materials manually, because each customer would be unique. They cannot create bill of materials beforehand and keep it ready. It had to be created dynamically. And we created a tool for them which would create this bill of materials on the fly, which kind of reduced the steps required from 3 hours to 3 minutes. And based on the MRP scheduling, which is out of box in Odoo, we were able to reduce 20% in the inventory. So that's basically cash, which you can use in your business. So I will just move over and show you some of the interesting thing we did for them. So you know Odoo has a product configurator, right? What we did, and we are really proud of this, we call it configuring the configurator. So we made a tool based on which they can set up rules of how an order can be placed, right? So if this is completely custom, which has been made for them. So this is a product I have. And these are the different steps. It includes fabric. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you so much. Okay, so this is a product where you see it's we create something called configuration templates, where you can define the different steps in the configurator. Before that, I'll show you the variants. So these are the variants for this particular product. So if they get an order for this product, these are the options which are available when you're configuring this. Required means this particular attribute is in, you need to fill in information for this attribute. Multi means you can have multiple selections when you're selecting this product. And so these are the different values which are there for the product. And this is the configurator. And this is where we configure the configurator. So for fabric, these are the different attributes which are available. We have something called restrictions. So if you have selected a certain product, you cannot use some of the different combinations. So you can have, you can create restrictions for your configurator. And this is where we specify which part of your process is manufactured under which work order, right? Under which operation. This is where you select that my fabric has these options available and it is consumed, it is done in this operation called cut and sew. And this is the work order where it is done. So essentially, this we have configured a system where they can actually add these options when they get an order. So what I will do is I will go to a sale order and probably try to create a new one. And I select configure my product. So this is just, product. I'll select my template here. And this is where I can select the attributes. The list of attributes come up, where this is what I need to, I can select which attributes the order needs to have. Here is where I will, the options. So these options, as you see, these are dynamically created, right? Based on my based on how I configured my configurator, I have these options available, and I'm creating creating the options here for the different values. And obviously, if you see, if I click on next, it will tell me that, hey, some of the attributes are actually required, which is what I configured in my template. And and select these options. And what the system has done with the options which I have created is in the backend, it has gone and using the options which I have selected, it created a bill of material on the fly. So this is my bill of material, which was created for a previous order. It has the options which I selected in that template, it has used that and created this bill of material on the fly. And also once I confirm my order, it has this the manufacturing order, which has the dynamically created bill of material available. One more important feature we've done is for such companies which have custom manufacturing, sometimes they get changes in the customers call in and tell them, hey, I don't want this option, instead I want this other option. So for them, we created an option to change the variance from the manufacturing order. So I can actually go into my manufacturing order and and I can actually change this fabric from Yoneka to some other fabric. So the customer called and said, hey, I wanted to change this, and they do that. I have a change history here of what I actually changed. Once I apply the changes, the dynamically created bill of material will be updated, and my entire manufacturing process will now use this new raw material instead of what was there in the order, and it will automatically update in the sale order as well. So this is something which we have done for them. So that is overall what we have done for a customer. So with our Odoo implementation, we help them improve the accuracy of the financial data. This is after you've implemented the regular Odoo. Some of the benefits which you get is that you get accurate financial data in the sense that your inventory is completely linked with the accounting system. Odoo has real-time inventory posting, which means as you get products, as you manufacture them, as you produce them, your inventory valuation is accurate, which means the systems are not disjoint. You get visibility into your production process. For this particular customer, we dramatically reduce the lead time for them so that they can turn around faster with their customers, and we had better communication internally and externally. So that is about our implementation. Any questions?
I am going to ask if anyone does have any question. Let's just wait for the microphone. We're live streaming and recording this on YouTube, so it just makes it easier to hear the questions. Anyone have any questions for Faisal? Sure.
So you mentioned that if it is in Oracle or SAP, it would have been taken more time. So how big the project is actually? How many people deployed in that project, and how much is the budget for this project?
So it was a sizable company which was doing custom manufacturing. In terms of our team which we implemented, we had a team of 8 people, and this was for a period of 1 year. The overall cost, I cannot share the overall cost with you, but it was essentially a 12-month process. We don't have the entire team of 8 people throughout the process. Essentially, when you're doing the business analysis process, we have just a couple of people, and then we ramp up the teams, as we do more customization and during the development phase and towards the end, as we have the training and UAT done, then we ramp down the team, right? So that's what we do.
How hard was it to implement the customer supplied materials? Because we run into that in our business where they buy the material from us, but they store it on our location so we can build it for them.
Okay, yeah, so a custom development which we had to do, which is we called it customer owned inventory. And in this particular industry, it's very standard for the customer to say, hey, this is my fabric, you know, take it and use it. So the way you receive it, it's obviously not your inventory. It needs to be in a separate location, which is virtual location, which belongs to the customer. So you can't count that valuation as yours, but you still need to track it. And once you're done, you either ship it back to them or do whatever they ask for it. So we had a custom development for that. If you want, I can set up a demo and show you how that process actually works. But it was a little bit of customization. Yeah.
Have any other questions? All right. If not, let's give Faisal another warm round of applause.
Thank you.
Give yourselves another one. You made it to the end of the day. And we hope you all join us at the beer garden for beer or wine. That's more your speed. And thanks again. See you all soon.